Afternoon class. Today we are revising over the previous chapter, that is GIMP 2.8. So in this chapter we have to learn this image manipulating program, that is GIMP. Some more other programs we are using for image manipulation, that is MS Paint, Photoshop, CorelDRAW. MS Paint has limited edition features. Photoshop has advanced features, but it is not free. CorelDRAW has also a lot of features, but it is also not free. GIMP, GNU Image Manipulation Program, is an advanced image manipulation program which is freely downloadable from the internet. Okay, so this is the site of GIMP from where you can download the GIMP for your computer. Okay, in address bar the address is given. You have to type this same address in your Chrome window and you can able to download the GIMP for your computer. Okay. Now next, this is the GIMP interface. In left hand side there is toolbox is given and tool options is given of a selected tool. In center main dock window, image window is given where your canvas is present for editing. In right hand side, brushes, patterns, gradients, layers, all things are given in right hand side. Okay. Now this is multiple window mode where the all windows are in multiple window mode. So you can float all the windows in different direction or position. Okay, so in multiple mode window you can float your images screens in different positions. And in single mode window, the full software window is in single mode. So when you are moving your window, the whole window is moving like only a single mode window. Okay. Now selection tools, the main part of this chapter is selection tools. In the image manipulating programs, there are different selection tools is present. Like in this screen, you are able to see the rectangle select tool, ellipse select tool, free select tool, or lasso select tool, fuzzy select tool, by color select tool, intelligent scissor select tool. Okay, all the shortcuts are also given in this screen in the ending of the name of the selection tools. Okay. So one by one we have to learn the selection tools, but first we have to change the selected area. Like if you have selecting a particular area by any tool, now here is the step to change selected area. Click the rectangle select tool, click and drag to enclose an area for selection, release the mouse once your selected area is final. So by using the rectangle selection tool, you have to click and drag to enclose an area for selection, release the mouse once your selected area is final. So now you have selected a particular area of an image. Now steps to change selected area. You now have a selection in the shape of a rectangle. Now click the brush tool and paint on the picture. First you have started from the whole selection, then you selected a particular area. Now you are using a brush and you are stroking by the brush. So on the selected area, the brush is working, not on the full area. Okay. So this is the step to change your selected area from full area to a particular area. Okay. Now how to draw a rectangle? You can use rectangle or ellipse tool, selection tool to draw shapes. Select file, new, for making a new file first. For making a new canvas basically. Now select the width and height of your drawing canvas. Now select the size of your canvas. Now select the rectangle selection tool and draw a rectangular selection. Now, like this you had draw a rectangular selection. After that, select the foreground color in which you want to shape the boundary. Click on the foreground color and click on the shape boundary. Okay. So how can you do that? You have to go to the edit, stroke selection. In stroke selection, you have to click on the stroke button. Okay. Stroke line solid, anti-aliasing, and line width is 3 pixel, and now stroke. Okay. So this will give an outline to the selection, making it look like a shape. Press Ctrl Shift A to deselect the shape. Now deselect the shape, you have to press Ctrl Shift plus A. Okay. Use of selection tool. Now different selection tools that you are using. Why you are using that selection tools? Selection tools are used to isolate only the foreground part of an image. The particular selection that you are doing by using the selection tool, so you can able to change that foreground part of the selection of that image. Okay. Use of selection tools to indicate speed. A motion blur effect is applied to the background without affecting the foreground color. Also, you can use selection tools to making your images motion blur or any kind of blurry background properties without affecting the foreground properties. So different needs are there of the selection tools. Here also simple example is given, use of selection tools. A simple way to do a color test on a wall before actually buying a paint. So you can do a particular selection of a wall, apply the color and check whether the color is good or not for your wall. Okay. Use of selection tools. Another common example for the use of selection tool is to aid in colorizing black and white images. Okay. You can change the color image in black and white and black and white images in the color images. Now, one by one, we are going to learn each and every select tool. This is the free select tool. Like the image is given, you have to create a boundary by particular clicking on the selection part. Close your selection by connecting the current pointer location to the start location, the end location, and the start location will same to close the current connection. If you want to select the multiple areas, you have to press shift key while making selecting a new areas. The fuzzy select tool to select contiguous area of a similar color range. This is a fuzzy select tool. That one is the free select tool. Okay. So by fuzzy select tool, when you are taking on the particular color, it will select the color portion of a similar type of color areas around it. Okay. In this also, if you want to select the same color from the different areas, you have to press the shift key. So for this select tool, you can change the color range, okay, by clicking on the fuzzy tool, by setting the threshold value, okay. And to deselect the part, you have to click on the control shift A. Select none, control shift A. Always when you want to deselect the things, you have to click on the control shift A. Selection by color tool, it will select on a single click whatever color you have selected, it will select from the whole images that particular color in a single click of the mouse. Okay. Scissor select tool is also a type of select tool in which when you are moving your mouse, it is an intelligent scissor select tool, so it will draw a curve automatically where you are moving your mouse by getting the particular magnetic color area of that passing your mouse of the clicks. Okay. And you have also make an enclosed curve to activate the selection. Now this is the scissor select tool. You have to use a scissor select tool for getting the demonstration of that. Now, using tools from the menu, all tools are given the toolbox option. Now you are using the tools from the menu. So you have to go to the tools menu. Okay. Selection tools and all the selection tools are given there. Okay. After selection tools, the paint tools are given, transform tools are given and color tools are given in the tools menu. So paint tools are used to making drawing, painting, erasing and filling colors in the selections like brush tool, eraser, airbrush, ink, bucket fill, blend, pencil. These all are the selection tool, painting tools. Bucket fill tool is basically a fill tool by which you can fill a particular selected area in a single click. So first you have to click on the bucket fill tool. Next you have to select the foreground color of that bucket fill tool and go that area where you want to fill the color and click on that. So the bucket will color that color on your selected part which you have selected in the bucket fill tool. Okay. Examples are given. Now this is also example of bucket fill tool in which the pattern fill they are using to make a pattern filled using the bucket tool. Blend tool It is used to fill gradient of mix of two or more than two colors. Okay. By using blend tool, you are making this type of gradients. More than two colors you are using, and the shapes are given like linear, radial, circular. Many shapes are given in the blend tool. Okay. This is a blend tool. Examples are given here: linear, conical, shaped, spiral, bilinear, radial, square. Many shapes are there. After the blend tool, we are using the pencil or paintbrush tool. These both are slightly similar, but the effects of the strokes are different. In pencil strokes, that is the hard edges, and the brush strokes, that are the soft edges. Okay. By getting this example, you are able to use your pencil and paintbrush tool. Okay. Airbrush tool is type of also a brush tool, but it also more soft areas from the brush tools, and it is used to remove imperfection in a picture. It is basically a type of a spray tool. Okay, so when you are spraying it, very soft areas of colors will be sprayed on the image. The ink tool, basically ink tool, is also a type of pencil tool. It is used to make a calligraphic effect by a controllable nib to paint solid brush strokes. Size, shape, and angle of the nib define the type of calligraphic effects you are doing in your canvas. This is the sample of airbrush tool, and this is the example of ink tool. Okay. Eraser tool, basically eraser is used to rough the particular color or particular effect we are applying on the images. So by eraser tool, you can rough the properties that you are applied by using the pencil, airbrush tool, or any other tool. Or you can also make your background transparent by selecting no background layer in present. Okay. The example of eraser tool is given here. When the background color is selected, the Airtel logo is erased by white color, and when the background color is not selected, the blue color dots it erased by a transparent area. Okay, this is the transparent area when no color is selected there. More paint tools: clone tool, heat tool, blur, sharpen tool, smudge tool, dots tool. Okay. Clone tool, when you want to clone the particular part of the image, so you can use the clone tool. Okay, like image with a patch, red color patch, repaired by a clone tool. How it will repair? It will take a white part from a particular image and apply on that red color part. Okay, this is the clone tool. Here is the steps is given that how to use the clone tool. Press control button to start the selection and drag the cursor on the position in the image which you want to clone. The clone with control button press. Now leave the control button and with the left mouse button press, drag in the empty space where you want to reproduce the selected part. Okay, so try these steps to apply the clone tool. Heal tool is slightly similar to the clone tool. Use this tool also. This tool is used to removing small wrinkles, pimples, or spots in the photos. Blur sharpen tool. Steps are given here. Select the blur sharpen tool. Set required tool option in the toolbox. Now click the left mouse button and drag over the required part of the image. Repeatedly press the control key to toggle between blur and sharpen. Smudge tool, used to smudge colors in the area. Drag by using this tool. This kind of effect you can create by the smudge tool after using smudge. Dodge tool, good apple, rotten apple. You can make the good apple into the rotten apple by using the dodge or burn tool. Transform tools, it allows us to rotate, scale down, scale up, stretch, skew, change perspective, create mirror image, crop an image, and move a selection.
type of formations, original image, rotated image, scale to smaller image, sheared image, image with changed perspective, flipped image. All transform tools are used to give this type of different properties of transformations. Rotating an image, by using the rotate tool, you can use this kind of dialog box to rotate the image. Now, when you are going to save your image, there are two options given. First is saving your image in the .xcf extension. Two, again edit your saved file when you want to edit. So when you want to edit the file again and again, you have to save from the .xcf extension. .xcf extension, and if when you want to just make a final output of the image, you have to use the export option. Both options are given in the file menu. Click on the file, go to save as to save the file in a GIMP format, and when you want to export the image for use further with the final output, you have to use the file export option to export in JPG or PNG format. So this is our chapter in which selection tools, paint tools, transform tools we have to learn. And with this video, I am going to give you many more videos in which all tools are there, like how you are going to use all the tools with the practical steps. Okay, so I am going to give you that video also. So thank you the class. And please learning from these videos. Also, I'm going to give you more videos, so please learn from that video also. Thank you.